I have a confession to make. After 15 years as a developer, including a few as a principal engineer, I have decided to become an engineering manager. But before you hit the unsubscribe button, please let me explain. There were some questions in my head that made me consider this path. And after 6 months in the role, I have gathered some learnings that I think might be helpful for you if you're considering this path or if you want to stay far away from it. And today, I want to share them with you. Welcome to a manager story. I mean, a dev story. The role name and responsibilities may differ a bit between different companies, and the execution and style, as many leadership roles, is heavily influenced by the person doing it. But I will use Julius's definition. The job of a manager is to get better outcomes from a group of people working together. In the case of the engineering manager, or EM, the role combines technical expertise with managerial skills to lead engineering projects and teams effectively. There are three things managers think about every day. The first one is the purpose, or the why. It's making sure that your team knows what success looks like and cares about achieving it. Second one is people, or who. It's making sure we have the right people, the right skills, and people are motivated. The third one is the process, or the how. It's spending just enough time coordinating what needs to get done. In my experience, as you grow, the truly big changes in technology require a lot of coordination, clear communication, leadership, and of course, technology. Coding becomes the easy part. Convincing others to get behind an idea is more time consuming, but also more impactful. There's a few resources that help me look into this and consider if I wanted to take this path. I'll leave those resources in the description. The first one is the Principal Use Survey, where it's quite useful to see your work style based on your strengths. In my case, I'm an orchestrator. I'm quite good at connecting things together from different perspectives, which is a good skill to have as an AM. I'm also very eager to see the gaps in my skills and learn new ones. For this, Engineering Ladder site helped me visualize and communicate the overlaps and skills between my role as a tech lead or principal engineer and potentially as an engineering manager, so I could look to expand in specific areas. Finally, while learning new skills always has a long-term impact, most decisions aren't permanent. There's this idea of the engineer-manager pendulum by Charity Majors, which explains that the best developers and the best managers have either done or switched from time to time between these roles. And in 2024, with the end of the 0% interest rate, contributors with manager experience also provide more career opportunities, as analyzed by the Pragmatic Engineer. If you're considering becoming a manager, you may have heard some potential challenges, like the number of meetings increases, or that it's complex to change the focus into people. Some of the challenges I knew when I was thinking about making the change, but others I didn't. In my experience, coming from a principal engineer role, the number of meetings didn't change as much. Other things I knew or imagined, but I struggled to actually internalize them. For example, as a principal engineer, I cared about the team wellness, but as an EM, I'm responsible for them. During my first 6 months, I experienced some pains and learnings I did not expect. The first one is solving problems instead of coaching, or explaining versus inspiring. My whole career has been about solving problems and getting things done. So when someone comes to me with a problem, either technology-wise or people-wise, the first thing that I do is to try to think on potential solutions instead of focusing on helping them get to the solution. It sounds easy, but I have struggled a lot with this one, especially when I have limited time and I need all the things to also focus on. The role changes from explaining to inspiring. Second thing is delegating. From the Making of a Manager book, there are two things to consider when delegating. What's important to the organization and what can you do better than anyone else. For the things your report is equal or better than you, you should delegate. And for the things that you are better, unless they are the most important, you should delegate and coach. This is something that I have struggled with, especially for things that I really enjoy doing or that I'm really good at. And also, people don't like to get delegated things that others don't want. So for many things that I want to delegate, I need to match it with the personal preferences, skills, or growth opportunities. Third, knowing myself and being comfortable with being vulnerable. Vulnerable publicly. Your strengths and weaknesses are amplified as an EM. Among the reasons I wanted to become an EM was also to improve my weaknesses, like being more decisive and delegating more. But this is something I've also struggled with because there are now more decisions to make with more unclear boundaries and longer feedback loops. It can feel lonely to be an example or leader to others sometimes when you're struggling with some situations. Things like, if I'm not sure about the path, how will the team take that insecurity? Will it cause more confusion or unnecessary stress, for example? Or how to deal with misalignment with other leaders or some frustrations without poisoning the team? Redress and one-to-ones become great tools for this, and I have found that sharing my pain publicly creates more trust with my reports, with my manager and my peers, and also helps my mental health. One thing that I've learned is that by moving from contributor to manager, I now see interactions that I wasn't paying attention to before. Just by switching from being the one participating more in discussions to listening more and participating in other forums has opened me to see other perspectives that I was blind to before. If you're considering becoming an engineering manager, here are some tips from my short tenure in the role. First, know yourself. Do some self-knowledge exercises. For example, are you comfortable dealing with your weaknesses more publicly? Or what strengths are you going to be using to help you in the first few months? Remember, everything you do will get amplified now. Second, focus on one thing at a time. You will probably see many things that you would like to improve, but it's impossible to tackle all of them at once. Many tasks have unclear boundaries, and it takes more time to see the effects of your actions. Like, for example, when do you know that the long-term vision worked and when do you stop working on it? Switching focus too much can also leave you confused about what has worked and what hasn't. And you cannot solve these issues alone, so make sure that you involve the team on those. Third, care about people and rely on others. One of the major pressures that I get as a manager is that people rely on me. Caring about others' well-being and growth can put a lot of pressure on you and it's draining. If you don't spend the effort and focus on them, you risk wasting people's time, careers, efforts, and company resources. Transitioning into a manager role can be very stressful, or at least it has been for me. And it's better to do it with the most information. If you're looking for more resources, I have put some in the description section. And now it's your turn. Do you want to become an engineering manager? Or if you're an engineering manager, what tips do you have for someone considering changing or starting in the role? I'll read you in the comments. Thank you for watching. Staying technical is important even if you take the management path. There are many resources that can help you keep your technical skills up to date. Today, I want to tell you about Code Crafters. Code Crafters create advanced level programming challenges for software engineers. These are very complete and in-depth, and the content and approaches are reviewed by top talent. They have great hands-on tutorials like build your own Redis or build your HTTP server. You can also improve your programming language skills with one of the more than 15 trainings focused on language. I've partnered with them and you can get 40% using this link. It's also in the description. Happy hacking!